Hello, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Speed Jaminator 3 channel for another episode of my Formula 1 2021 My Team J4 Career Mode. This is episode number 136, and we're at the U.S. Grand Prix at the COTA. If you missed the previous Formula 1 race, it was the a championship-deciding race. It was the Italian Grand Prix in Monza. Be sure to check it out on my live streaming on twitch.tv/speedjaminator3. And then also check it on youtube.com/speedjaminator3 and follow up and subscribe to my channel on the purple heart and then also on the subscribers button down below to follow up and subscribe to my channel on live streaming twitch.tv/speedjaminator3. And then if you want to click on the red bell to your right, you can subscribe to youtube.com/speedjaminator3. Now, excuse me for my previous race. I thought I wanted my 40th championship, but it was actually my 38th driver's championship. So you proved me that was wrong. It was my 38th Formula One World Championship. I had to check my career stats just to make sure that it was indeed correct. And it was my 38th Formula One championship that I won, that I clinched at the Italian Grand Prix in Monza. And I did such a great job over there. It was a very, very good race at the Italian Grand Prix in Monza as we won our driver's championship. But now we can clinch our constructor's title here at the U.S. Grand Prix if Alain Prost can try to finish fourth or better. And if he does, and if we finish 1-2, that'll be great. And then we'll be able to clinch the constructor's championship. Now, we thought we were going to have rain coming into the area. We also had a regulation change this season in Season 7 because we haven't had it in the past two seasons, but we did have it this season. But it doesn't really matter about that. And then also Daniel Ricciardo's retirement, but it's going to be short-lived anyway because next week when we transition into the Formula 1 22 game, he'll be racing on our career mode anyway. So we will see how the retirements are going to be for the Formula 1 22 game when that comes out in a week and a half. And the weather forecast, well, we're going to have partly cloudy skies in qualifying, so that means cloudy skies are going to make it faster racing conditions in qualifying. And then also in the race, it will be pretty much the same like it was in the Italian Grand Prix. Sunny weather and then partly cloudy and then cloudy at the end of the race. And this is our first post-championship race for episode number 136 of My Team J4 Career Mode. So hopefully we can get pole position or maybe get a top 10 out of this one. So let's get to it. Let's get running here in the U.S. Grand Prix, my home race circuit in Austin, Texas at Dakota. Here we go. And then we're driving our home race livery car for this race. We put lime green and we put the yellow on it and a little bit of pink on this car. And we're all set and ready to go. And hopefully me and Alain Prost can set in some times of a minute 29 or a minute 30. So we plan on another way to do it. And we also changed our engine for the final time this season. And it looks like we got Charles Leclerc, then we got minute 29.870, and Pierre Gasly is also in a minute 29. Man, everybody is rocking the pace with a minute 29. And hopefully we will too with the new engine.
Thank you.
was down in P12, and we didn't get a faster lap. It's not fast enough. We gotta get another lap out of it. Still not fast enough, but it may could get us into the second qualifying round. It was a minute and 30, but we're still running a little bit too slow. Man, it is so close, but we still have to get it up there. Well, we got into P11, but we have to get faster than a minute and 30. Because Lewis Hamilton, look at this, that's a surprise. Lewis Hamilton has qualified in P1 with a minute 29.755. Pierre Gasly is second, Max Verstappen third. And Leclerc is fourth, and Carlos Sainz rounds up the top five. But Alain Prost and I, we're two car lengths better, but we need to get a little bit more quicker. Man, what a surprise. Lewis Hamilton is the fastest. Still running a little bit too much push on the car. It's not fast enough. It's a minute and 30.619. That is still not fast enough. Man, that is a nice time. Minute 29.752. That was a fantastic lap on the second lap. And that put us into P3. And that may be fast enough to try to make it into the top 10. That was a phenomenal qualifying in the second lap. Man, great job, guys. It looks like I found the cuts. And then I found the speed, and it paid off. But good job by my teammate, Lon Cross. He's a minute 29.396. So, minute 29.752, and that is fast enough to make it into the third qualifying round. It ain't over yet. Nobody's going to be beating me at my home track at the U.S. Grand Prix. Great job. Let's see if we can continue to maybe go into the front row, maybe next to our teammate, Lon Cross. Maybe the cloudy weather is going to help us. Well, Lon Cross is still the fastest with a minute 29.667. It's a minute 29.781, but it's P7. Well, we'll be able to beat the rain anyway. And that puts me up into P2. Minute 29.661. But is it fast enough to be on the front row? I think we might not make it P2. But it looks like everybody else had beat the rain. But that puts us and drops us into P6. But that's okay, because we got P6.
We're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
Well, I'm very glad we got the fastest lap with a minute 29.661. But it looks like the second effort, it looks like everybody barely just beat out the rain. I thought we were going to be in P2, but then we dropped into P6. So we'll be starting in row 3 on the outside next to Carlos Sainz. But a great effort and a good qualifying. I'm very proud of that. And me and Alon Cross did an excellent job. So I'll be in my home race circuit racing in P6.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. Made it look easy. How did it feel to be racing on home turf?
Well, it felt fantastic. We had a good qualifying. We gave it a great effort. But if the rain came in a little bit... later than that, then we could have locked into a front row in P2, but that's all right. P6 will be just fine.
Why do you think you weren't as quick as your teammate today?
Well, my teammate Alon Cross did a very good job. He got a better qualifying, and he was a tick faster than me, but we are ready to have a 1-2 finish and see if we can try to get our 36 Constructors title. No, it won't be a problem tomorrow. We'll try to go up front, and then we have a great car, and we'll be there in the end of the race.
After all the teams have updated their cars for next season's regulation changes, where do you think you'll come out?
Well, it's always a dice roll, but we won't be in next season and everything, because we're going to be going to the new Formula 1 22 game, and this is our final two episodes coming up, and we have to start everything all over again, and the new gen cars are going to be awesome.
Appreciate your time.
Well, hopefully we get some grid penalties from some of these drivers. I did make an engine change on this car, so we will be able to be faster. But good job by Alon Prost getting a P4, and then I'll be starting in P6. And I guess the best qualifying of the race was in the qualifying session number 2, as I jacked in there and then moved up, and then was qualified enough to be in the final qualifying session. And we're getting ready for the race at the U.S. Grand Prix, episode number 136. And it's going to be clear, and then after that it will be cloudy, but no rain to be worried about. Let's hope that me and Alon Prost will have a good race today, and he's in his final two races of the season of My Team Jayco Career Mode, episode number 136, in our first post-championship race of the season. Hopefully we'll have a very good and awesome perfect race here at the COTA in the U.S. Grand Prix, and then in Formula 1 22, in about a week and a half, we will have two U.S. Grand Prix. We'll have U.S. Miami and U.S. COTA for right now when Formula 1 22 comes out. All right, let's get ready to go. 56 laps of racing at my home turf at the U.S. Grand Prix. episode number 136. Let's have a great American bash at the COTA.
Here we are then in one of the fastest growing cities in the United States, the fabulous Austin in the great state of Texas. The circuit itself, 14 miles southeast of the city center and home to the U.S. Grand Prix since 2012. The latest in a long list of iconic tracks to have that honor. We have 10 turns to the left and 10 to the right here at the fantastic Circuit of the Americas. Overtaking opportunities into turn 1 and 12 at this anti-clockwise 3.6 mile track. And we should see average lap speeds of around 126 miles per hour.
All right, this is starting grid by home turf of the U.S. Grand Prix.
It looks for today's race. A fantastic effort from Pierre Gasly yesterday puts him on pole, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Prost, Carlos Sainz, Hulk, Leclerc, Norris, Hamilton, and Christian Lundgaard, Tsunoda, Stroll, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Ricciardo, Ocon, Ireland, Mick Schumacher, and Nicholas Latifi, Schwartzman, Joe, Mazepin, and Nobuharu Matsushita. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
So Nobuharu Matsushita took a grid penalty.
Okay, I know it's your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Don't take unnecessary risks.
Now, with the race director, anybody going with the set of mediums? I don't think anybody is. So we'll be starting in P6 as the way it stands right now. And then Pierre Gasly is second in points, but he can't clinch the championship now because now he has to settle for a runner-up position. And he has had a good short season in the Formula 1 2021 My Team Jaguar career mode. And Lando Norris and I got a little bit of a falter there, but we're starting fourth and sixth, but we'll be able to make our way to move up front. And now our race strategy is going to look like this, but we could make it into a three-stop, well, instead of a three-stop effort, we could make it as a two-stop effort if we can do it like this. But if these tires can last long and everything, and then try to lead at this point, then we'll be able to be setting free for a good finish. So this is all about the strategy here at the U.S. Grand Prix at the COTA. So we stay out there for maybe 16 laps or so, and then stay out there longer with the other set of soft tires. Then we may be able to, maybe on lap 40, put on the medium tires, and then we'll be out there and then try to be up front. But we got five cars ahead of us, so that way we can try to make it up into the front. If we have a good car, and then we have a good beginning passing all these cars, then we'll be able to make it up front. And it's our first post-championship race, episode number 136 on my home soil. Let's get ready to run the U.S. Grand Prix. And it's almost over for the Formula 1 2021 game. We got this race and then two more and the final two episodes to go. The next one will be going to the Middle East for Middle East racing, and this is the last daytime race of the season. And just to let you know, this is our final daytime race of the season because the next two races are going to be both nighttime at Saudi Arabia and Abu Dhabi. Starting right in between the Scuderia Ferraris. Remember, those are all Ferraris and Mercedes took advantage of it. Toxic COTA today, if we now form into our formation grids. Coming on here in my home race. The U.S. Grand Prix is now underway. Nice start by Alain Prost. He moves up into the lead. Man, he had a phenomenal start. Oh, what a phenomenal start that was for Alain Prost. See if we can try to get around Science. Remember, we have no DRS zone. Easy pass right onto Carlos Sainz, and then we move up into P5. That was a very, very nice start for Pierre Gasly. The pole sitter drops into third place, and my teammate, Alain Prost, is now leading. Yeah, because I slipped all over the racetrack there, and then I couldn't get the pace. Thank you. see if I can try to get around Valtteri Bottas. I got a good chance to. Oh, darn it. Pierre Gasly couldn't even get out of the way. I was trying to get around Valtteri Bottas, and then suddenly I ran into Pierre Gasly. Well, I got into both of them, and I move up into P3. It was a dangerous pass, and I should have think of doing that in the first place instead of hitting the brakes, ramming into Pierre Gasly, because I know he does have a good car. Why does it always happen every time I make one mistake and then I ran into somebody while he's slowing down? Make sure we don't have any more mistakes like that again. Already. This is the best run of the season so far for Alain Prost, my teammate. He's finally getting something going.
6 seconds.
Closing in on Max Verstappen. It's the battle for second place for 1.3 seconds. And catching up with our teammate, Alain Prost. Strategy will be, and we're going to be going up to lap 18 to change over to the soft tire. So we're going to work on a little bit of a long strategy. Again on Verstappen, just about second place, 1.2 seconds behind. And we're pulling away from Bottas, about 3.4 seconds. Getting the DRS yet. We're still running a little bit loose in some of the corners. We have to cut it a little bit more better. And now we finally can get the DRS that we needed. A good chance to pass around after stopping. We had to hit the brakes very hard to try to get it to turn around and get around after stopping, and we sure did, and we move up into second place. Nice piece of running. Second on that one. I'm so sorry. I overturned it too much. Toxic Jayco now running 1-2. As I promised, that was going to be our projection. You know, the cost of the start of this race, he moved up into first place after Pierre Gasly had a slow start. And now Pierre Gasly has dropped back into the field because he had wing damage. Stop and now goes into the pits. He goes into the pits on lap 13. We don't pit until lap 18. now Alain Prost goes into the pits. And that will put us right into the lead. And we are now leading on my home race at the U.S. Grand Prix as Alain Prost pits. But we will have a free race advantage on the fresh tires. Seen both has signs for Leclerc or Tosunoda in the top five, but made it into the pits. Into the pits again. The leader, Alain Prost, has gone into the pits again. He has wing damage. Oh my goodness, what a tough break for my teammate Alain Prost. He has to pit again because he got caught with wing damage. Man, he had such a good lead. He had a terrific start in this race, and now all of a sudden he has to pit. Unscheduled pit stop for Alain Prost. And that might put me right into the lead. That is a tough break, you know. And now Alain Prost is off way back into the field. He must have had wing damage with somebody when he got caught up in traffic. Sonoda now goes into the pits. About a few seconds over there after hitting that bump going into the turn. Why did I hit that bump? And that is the third time Alain Prost has come into the pits with wing damage. I don't know what's going on with Alain Prost. This is the third wing damage he has had today. Coming into the pits. Was Max Verstappen in the lead, but remember, I got 3 laps fresh for tires to him, so I may be able to catch up on him right now. Gaining on Max Verstappen, 4 seconds now. Let's just keep the momentum going, keep the pressure on him, and we may have one car out of the race, and it's Sebastian Ocon. Esteban Ocon is out of the race with a blown motor. First DNF of the race here at the U.S. Grand Prix. Esteban Ocon in the Alpine is done for the day with a letting go of the motor. And we got the fastest lap, and Botas also gets the fastest lap. We're both running equal speeds at 1:33. And Ian Botas are really catching the gap now on Max Verstappen. Seconds now behind the Max Verstappen, and Valtteri Bottas is really getting pretty racy today. Closing in on Max Verstappen with 1.9 seconds behind. Closing in, 1.6 seconds, come on, close the gap. And Bottas is doing the same thing as well. It's now down to 1.2 seconds, and we're still almost getting on the nose of Max Verstappen. Thank you. Lewis Hamilton is running in sixth place right now. Running even speed in between for Verstappen and Bottas. This is a great racing here at the US Grand Prix. Hope we see that in the Formula 122 game, that close action racing and with clean air with those new cars.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
And we're going to be pitting on lap 36. That'll be our final pit stop to change over to the mediums. And we're right on the nose of Max Verstappen, and same goes with Bottas. We have the two fastest cars out there. I have the fastest Ferrari, and then Bottas has the fastest Honda. Verstappen goes into the pits, and I'm going to have DRS. That was very good racing between me and Max Verstappen, but now he has to pit. I won't be able to pit until lap 36. And me and Bottas are pretty much going to be staying out there. close action competitive racing between me and Valtteri Bottas. Well, he loses it a little bit going into that turn. That gave me about six car lengths and was 3.6 seconds ahead of Sainz. And Antonio Giovinazzi is the second car out of the race. Blown motor. That's the second blown motor of the race. First it was Ocon and now Giovinazzi. Oh, safety car is out. So that is the first safety car of the race, and now we have no choice of going into medium tires. We were after 31 of 56 laps. And we have no choice, we have to pit. And we're going to pit for medium tires, and that means we can make it all the way through the finish. So hopefully that maybe possibly catch up a long cross to move up in the field. Coming into the pit to make our final pit stop. This will lead us all the way to the pit.
It's it now. You'll be racing to leave the pit. Complete. Go now. Look after these tires now. We will finish the race on this compound.
And Valtteri Bottas just beat us in the pits. But Verstappen is the only one that could be the sitting duck here. He didn't even pit. We put it on lap 28, but remember, we put it on lap 32, and we can make it all the way to the end. Safety car came out on lap 30. Lap 30, it came out. But Max Verstappen could be losing track position because he did not pit to change over to the mediums. So it looks like Bottas and I and everybody else will be in great shape, and it already bunches up the field. Good run for Christian Lundgaard. He's running in seventh place right now. Have a good restart here before the safety car comes into the pits. See if we can try to get around Bottas. We just lost the position over Bottas over the pit stop. And we get around Bottas and we move up into second. Bottas has to pit because he's got wing damage. I was just trying to get around him, and then he just ran out of room. And that puts Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz into third and four. Verstappen has better tires than I do because he's running on the soft tires, but he has to pit one more time, and then it is going to lose him a lot of track position. Lando Norris now moves up in the P3. He passes around Charles Leclerc because he's running on the soft tires as well. After 38 of 56 laps, we have 19 laps remaining in the U.S. Grand Prix, and I'm still running in second place, but I do have the advantage because I took home the medium tires to go right to the end. And it could be three Ferraris once again, just like we did in the Italian Grand Prix at Monza, to finish in the top three. And Lando Norris is catching. But with that safety car, they did not pit on that pit, on that last pit stop. And they may give up a ton of track position because it's still a freight train over the line. Verstappen is getting good straightaway speed with those soft tires. And it's still 5 seconds ahead right now of Lando Norris for P2. Still running about under 3 seconds. Lots remaining here at the U.S. Grand Prix. Verstappen goes into the pits. Verstappen comes into the pits on lap 41. And now we'll give me the lead, and let's see if I can hold on to it. And then Norris might be out able to pit as well. And Norris is going to stay out. But Max Verstappen has given up a lot of track position after not pitting during the safety car period. Christian Lugard, his teammate, is now running in fifth place, so taking the advantage of his soft tires. now I got the two Ferraris, so Leclerc and Sainz, they will be running second and third after Norris pits. Hold on to this lead within about 14 laps remaining. Well, actually, 14 laps remaining here at the U.S. Grand Prix, and we win our home circuit once again with the strategy. Due for a pit stop. He's 3.5 seconds ahead. And here comes Norris. He's coming into the pits. That will put Leclerc and Sainz into second and third place. And Tsunoda also goes into the pits. Pulling away from Carl Leclerc. We're almost about 9 seconds ahead of him on medium tires. And this is a good sign, so that means we will be able to try to win this race at my home circuit once again in the U.S. Grand Prix with the strategy. He did a nice job making that pit stop and making the right move going into the safety car area, making that pit stop and taking advantage. About the 9 second advantage. It's the Ferrari's 1-2-3 once again, like it was in the previous race in the Italian Grand Prix of Monza. And Schumacher and Latifi now going to the pit to make their final stop. And look who's running in four. Pierre Gasly. What a comeback by Pierre Gasly. And then running in fifth is Max Verstappen. He's about 16 seconds ahead with fresher medium tires. And Ron Foss got to pass the flat, but he's running on soft. The Pierre Gasly is running about maybe 5 seconds ahead of the two Ferraris. In the USA Grand Prix, it is all about the strategy here at the Circuit of the Americas, and we really have paid it off. We got about 12 laps remaining. We're up to 45 of 56 laps with a 9.7 advantage over Leclerc. We've been doing that all throughout this race. With 10 laps remaining here in the U.S. Grand Prix, and the home crowd is starting to cheer up the Speed Tapinator in my home circuit. And it's going to be another unprecedented toxic race at the Circuit of the Americas again. Playing this strategy right and pulling away from Charles Leclerc about 10.7 seconds, and Verstappen is still sitting back with 15 seconds ahead. He's still running in fifth place, about a second behind, but he is closing in on Pierre Gasly for P4. Leclerc and Sainz are still running even Steven right now. Verstappen now gets by Gasly, and he moves up into P14. But Verstappen's now going to have a lot of pressure with those two skinnier Ferraris. And it's beginning to cloud up here, but no rain in sight for the COTA. Verstappen's going to have a hard time catching up with the Scuderia Ferrari. He's still 4 seconds, and he is catching up on him, but it's going to be too little too late for him to get around the Scuderia Ferrari, and I'm using them as a pick so they can give me an advantage, and then in the last 8 laps, I'll be coming out victorious here at the U.S. Grand Prix, but I still need to be careful out there and not make any more miscue mistakes. Come on, keep the pressure on. Got Max to stop him. Scuderia Ferrari, you're doing great. Not been a good day for the Lanfranc, and then once again the Lanfranc gets wing damage. That's already the fourth time today he has had wing damage. He has had a terrible, terrible day in my home race circuit at Dakota. And I've been having a very bright day here at Dakota, and now he might have to change over to soft tires. He has made 5 pit stops with wing damage. He has been just overdoing it all the time. Verstappen with those fresh medium tires is about 2 seconds now behind Carlos Sainz. But the laps are just closing down, and I'm taking advantage of it. The key moment of the race was pitting under the safety car on lap 32 and then lasting these tires all the way to the end. And Verstappen could be having a verge of being too late to catch around me. Because he's still getting a pressure, he's still not driving around the two Scuderia Ferraris. We're going to have to take a look at that race director to see how many times Alain Prost had wing damage and had to pit so many times, and he is in a dead last and not having a great race at all. He started out so great, and then after the first round of pit stops, then he had the first contact with wing damage, and then he suffered it again. Verstappen is now going to be trying to close in on the two Ferraris to break up the Scuderia Ferrari party so he can try to settle for a podium position. And he is running out of time, and he is not going to be catching me at all, because I am a good 13 seconds ahead of Verstappen, all the way from down the P4 to the lead. Nice lap, a minute 33 even on that lap, with 4 laps remaining. Laps to go, 12.279 seconds ahead of Charles Leclerc. He's looking for another podium finish, and this will be the second podium finish in a row for the Scuderia Ferrari. he's played 12 seconds now over Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz. They're also trying to hold on to podium position and keep Max Verstappen out of the way. Max Verstappen, about 14 laps ago, made a pit stop on lap 40 and lost valuable track time. Everybody else was running with softs, and they gave up a lot of track time as well. And then that's what knocked them out for podium position. Because the Ferrari side made the right move to go to the medium tires on lap 30, and they're taking advantage. They're in a 1-point advantage right now over the Scuderia Ferraris. And Pierre Gasly is just still sitting like a duck out there, not doing anything. He is closing in on the Scuderia Ferraris, but he's running out of time, and we only got 2 laps remaining. 2 to go here at the COTA. Going for another impressive win in my home race circuit. And this will be about the 39th time I won in my home race circuit at the U.S. Grand Prix. It's going to be another horrible finish for Prost, because in the previous race he blew an engine in the Italian Grand Prix of Monza. He was running in 5th place, and he's having another dismal race here at my home race circuit, the U.S. Grand Prix. And the next time around will be the final lap here at the COTA to win another unprecedented home race in my home turf. Coming down the line, final lap here at the U.S. Grand Prix, one more time around. And we're going to do it with under 12 seconds now over Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz, and they're still holding on to second and third place to keep Max Verstappen out of podium position. And good comeback by Pierre Gasly, who finishes in 5th place. In this final turn, we've got the final 2 corners to go at the U.S. Grand Prix, and what an impressive job that we did in the strategy, and we've done it again in the U.S. Grand Prix as we win for the 38th time in my home race. We win the U.S. Grand Prix in Dakota again under the strategy. And driver of the day goes to Nobuhiro Matsushita. I don't know where he finished, but he looks like he finished an impressive job.
With it, the championship is secure. It's been a magnificent season, and they thoroughly deserve the cheers of the crowd here today. Talk to me, Hans. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly. We've seen teams in the past throw away wins because they were too hesitant, but here they were decisive, and that's allowed them to take the advantage.
What an impressive job and an impressive race today. We did it with one miscue, ramming into Pierre Gasly, but then we finally got around him around that corner. Then he had wing damage, and the safety car came out, and And that really helped Pierre Gasly, and then he managed to do it with the medium tire strategy two times and finish in P5. And for the second race in a row, all Ferraris have swept 1-2-3 again. We swept it again, like we did in the previous race at the Italian Grand Prix of Monza, and then we do it here at the U.S. Grand Prix at the COTA. Going 1-2-3 again. Me and the team, Toxic J-Po Ferrari, and then the Scuderia Ferrari, second and third again.
Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Nobuharu Matsushita gets my vote today.
The Constructors' Championship may be a foregone conclusion at the moment, but regardless, let's look at the standings. With that result, the sport's newest team can no longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many have written off a short time ago. They are Formula One World Champions. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
Man, and another impressive top 10 finish for Christian Lundgaard. And that's the second race in a row he has finished in the top 10. AlphaTauri's have really been juicing it up with their points position. And another impressive day for the Scuderia Ferrari, says Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz and I did it on strategy, staying with the medium tires after the safety car, and come away with podium finishes and another sweep for Ferrari. So myself, I get the win, and then Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz get podium, and Max Verstappen gets a dismal fourth place. And full center Pierre Gasly, he made a great comeback. After starting way over the back, and then he finishes in P5, and then Lando Norris goes into 6, Tsunoda, Hamilton, good job, P8, Christian Lundgaard, another great job, P9, and Daniel Ricciardo gets the final point spot for a top 10 finish. And then in the standings, we have 196 points. We get our 7th win, so we win 7 out of the last 8 races in Formula 1. And it was a great episode, number 135, for winning here at the U.S. Grand Prix. And officially, we have won our 36th Constructors title. We won 38 champion drivers titles in the championship, and we win our 36th Constructors Championship. And Ferrari has been surging up the table, and they should still have a chance to get that runner-up finish by the end of the season if they do well in the final two races, if they keep having a performance like this in Saudi Arabia and Abu Dhabi in the grand finale. The Team Toxic J-Po clinches the Constructors' Championship with 95 points over to Mercedes, and then Ferrari finishes in third, AlphaTauri, and Red Bull rounds out the top 5. And Lewis Hamilton moves up to 7th, and then Charles Leclerc, well, that he needed that good run, and he finishes in 9th place as Alain Prost keeps on dropping. But he needs to do good in the next two races to close out the Formula 1 2021 game. Let's take a look at the highlights of the race as we started in P6, and then we move our way up in the strategy. We led the last 17 laps of the race, and came out with a strategy victory over at the U.S. Grand Prix. A little bit of an edgy start there, but I managed to slow down, and then I got right behind Carlos Sainz. And Alain Prost had an impressive day early in the race, as he went from fourth all the way to the lead. And here's this nice sweeping pass getting by Bottas and Gasly. And I got both of those drivers by for fourth and third place. And in lap 11, this is when I got by Max Verstappen. Easy pass. Thank you. Then during the safety car period, then we restarted on lap 33 in third place because Botas had a better pit stop than I did. And I was able to get around him here cleanly, and that was a clean pass right through him, and then got around him for P2. But then Max Verstappen had the better tires, but then he put it on lap 40, and then I came out in the lead, led the last 16 laps, and then the two Ferraris put the pressure on him, victorious for the 38th time in my home race at the U.S. Grand Prix. Great racing, and great strategy it was for me, Leclerc, and Sainz to get that podium finish. Well, there was no pressure at all with me. It was a far easy race. I was a little worried in the beginning of the race. That I thought maybe we wouldn't win this race, but I felt so sorry for Alain Prost, and he could have had a car to win this race. He was leading, he had a great start, but then poor wing damages got him into a worse, disastrous position. He lost a lot of it, and I feel sorry, but let's see if he do well in the final two episodes of our Formula 1 2021 game when we go to Jeddah Circuit at the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix.
We all underestimated you, didn't we?
Yeah, everyone underestimated me. It was a great race. We feel at home winning in Austin, Texas again and winning our home race circuit.
Which department has been hit the hardest by next year's regulation changes?
It's mostly been the chassis has been hit the hardest, and then everything else has been hitting hard as well too, with the durability and then also the powertrain.
Do you think you were lucky not to end your race with that crash?
Well, I was lucky enough. I was getting around easily over Pierre Gasly, and then also I was lucky not to end my crash and end my day after I got around Valtteri Bottas, and we did a great job out here. And another accomplishment in the bag, winning our home race at the U.S. Grand Prix. And then also my rivalry was Esteban Ocon, but he DNF in the race. And we're taking a commanding lead on the rivalry breakdown over him from 21 to 7. We didn't achieve pole position, but we're still keeping all of our sponsors handy. And that's why Alain Prost had four wing damages during this race, and then that cost him a lot of damage reduction in cash after all those wing damages, and then finishing so badly. But he'll be able to get back and recover and rebound in the next one when we go to Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. We have final two episodes left to go. And in episode number 137,
the Team's income is
will be the first two night races.
It's time for you to have a think about our profit margin.
So we're going to do it for the last and final time. Renew our sponsors. So we'll have that as a sponsor for the last and final time in our Formula 1 2021 game. And then also Equita Oil. So those will be our final two sponsors for the last two episodes of my Formula 1 My Team J-Pro Career Mode. So we are now officially done with the daytime races. And officially there you see that we have won the Constructors' Championship for the 36th time. And we won the Constructors' titles just enough to beat out the Mercedes. So Mercedes will have to settle for a second-place position, but they're getting a lot of pressure now over the Ferraris. And the Alvataris have been doing great in fourth place. This is their best run that they had all season long. And then Red Bull only about a single point behind them. Impressive racing was at the U.S. Grand Prix, and that was our 78th total win in our career in this Formula 1 2021 game. We have 106 podium finishes, 20 poles, and 6 drivers and constructors championships. And now the last two races, it will be prime time night racing, at the Jeddah circuit as we run the third running of the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix, and then we take home the party in our last and final Formula One 2021 game of our career, the grand finale in the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. And thank you so much for watching on the Speed Japanator 3 channel, and we will close our coverages and we will come back tomorrow to run the third running of the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix at the Jeddah circuit. Let's see if we can make it to two seasons in a row winning there, and it's going to be fast competitive racing when we get around the fastest street circuit in Formula One in Saudi Arabia. And thanks everyone so much for watching, and hopefully Alain Prost will rebound from that dismal 19th place in my home race at the U.S. Grand Prix. And we'll have a great library car for the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix for the next one. So thanks everyone for watching. I hope everybody has a good night. Be sure to get plenty of rest and take care. And then also I wish everybody a happy Father's Day too. For all you fathers out there, all you guys, happy Father's Day weekend. And I hope you make it safe and clean and sound for our greeting weekend. So have a nice evening, everyone. We'll see you in the next one. And take care.